morning, everyone. I'd like to go over with you the entrance antiphon for our Mass today for special needs. It can be found in your missalettes on page 4 under the 25th Sunday of Ordinary Time. We're going to begin by intoning the Alleluia. Everybody can just follow me. I'll sing it once. It goes like this.
Alleluia.
Chancellor, who has been here and hosted you in years past, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Welcome, everyone, and we celebrate this Mass, coming in our minds and our hearts, all the people in the Archdiocese of San Antonio with special needs. May the Lord give them what they need. May the Lord provide for their care, and may the Lord bless their families as they dedicate themselves to the service of all His precious brothers and sisters. Let us now be mindful of our sins as we prepare ourselves to celebrate worthily these sacred mysteries.
I confess,
O my God, and to you, my brothers and sisters,
that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, blessed memory of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. O Lord, have mercy.
your sacred law, upon love of you and of our neighbor. Grant that by keeping your precepts, we may merit to attain eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Where jealousy and selfish ambition exist, been peaceable, gentle, compliant, full of mercy and good fruits, without inconstancy or insincerity. And the fruit of righteousness is sown in peace for those who cultivate peace. Where do the wars and where do the conflicts among you come from? Is it not from your passions that make war within your members? You covet but do not possess. You kill and envy but you cannot obtain. You fight and wage war. You do not possess because you do not ask. You ask but do not receive because you ask wrongly. You spend it on your passions. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
dear people of God, members of Alhambra, who have been so gracious over the years to help families to take care of those members of theirs who are in special needs. Thank you for being here. Father Peter, Provincial Missionaries of the Holy Spirit, who is visiting us, going through very challenging situations in his family. Missionaries of the Holy Spirit, especially my friends with special gifts. I would like my friend, come here. Will you come here? Yeah, my good friend. Yes, my friend. The Lord wants to reach out today as we pray to all these beautiful friends who are everywhere and that we want to have in our minds and our hearts as a special brothers and sisters, knowing that they help the church in many ways to achieve the mission, because they are loving, they are caring, and with their purity of heart and mind, help us all to be closer to that. This message is for all of us based on the scripture today, but especially to them. Does anyone here love Jesus? Some of you, because of your masks, I'm not sure you answer. Does anybody here love Jesus?
Yes.
I know you love Jesus. But you know what? He loves you even more. He loves you more than you love him. And whenever you think you can love him more, he loves you even more. He even loves you more than those who care for you. And no matter how hard they try to love you, Jesus will always love you more than that. There is no other way around it. God's love is big, 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 big. And deep, deep, one can be Jesus in his love for us. And let me tell you a secret. You, brothers and sisters with special needs and special gifts, you are his favorite. You and those who serve you, because Jesus said that if anyone wishes to be first, he shall be the last of all and the servant of all. So, thank you, all of you who care for these precious brothers and sisters. Your witness is eloquent in the church and for the sake of the world. We are all God's children. And in today's gospel, Jesus took a child. He placed it in the midst of the apostles. And putting his arms around the child, he said to them, whoever receives one child like this in my name receives me. And whoever receives me receives not me, but the one who sent me. We are all aware how people with special needs, no matter their age, they are deep inside like a little child. And though, like regular children, sometimes it can get difficult. All people with special needs have precisely the heart of a child that Jesus pointed out. Because it's not the age, it's the quality of life, the quality of the soul, the quality of we should all try to be like children. They have a special kind of wisdom that we should not lose as we grow older or when we think that we are better. On the contrary, we should cultivate it like a small plant that little by little becomes a large, beautiful tree. The Apostle James describes that wisdom in the second reading today. It is, first of all, pure, then peaceful, gentle, compliant, full of mercy and good fruits, without inconstancy or insincerity. And the fruit of righteousness is sown in peace for those who cultivate peace. If you know people like that in your lives, try to learn from them. Genuine love is there. May Our Lady of Guadalupe raise us and
God's wisdom, I search him. We love children. We learn how to love from childlike children. May we take the challenge to love with purity of heart. Those who are in RCIA, please come forward. What a good lesson we received today. To be my dear friends, this community now sends you forth to reflect more deeply upon the Word of God, which you have shared us today. Be assured of our loving support and prayers for you, and we look forward to the day when you will share fully in the Lord's day. You have been called. Answer. God calls us together in this holy place. So now we call upon God to hear our prayers for all those who are in need.
For the church, that we may grow in holiness and mercy by God's grace, and that those virtues may be manifested in good fruits to benefit those in most need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the leaders of our nations that are at war, that they may find a way of peace and avoid further bloodshed, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For they may bring peace of mind to those who are afflicted. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For vocations, that our communities may promote and pray for those who call to the priesthood and consecrated life, that they may respond with gladness to their call. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our community, that we may be imitators of God, kind, compassionate, and forgiving of one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the sake of our parish community, in particular those whose names are written in our parish book of intentions and in our bulletin, may they be healed in mind, body, and spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Let us pray also for our brothers and sisters by our border in the northern United States. And we want to serve those who are coming directly to the Archdiocese, to the Rio. There are about 13,000 of them from Haiti, Venezuela, Cuba. Those are people like you and me in special need for welcome. May our authorities have a pure heart and see in them people with dignity, those who have been hurt by situations in life that need help. And may we as a church welcome them into our hearts and into our lives. For those refugees, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We ask all this in Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Estou ali.
graces with some brothers that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these gathering mysteries, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. Lift up your heart.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father of mercies and faithful God. For you have given us Jesus Christ, your Son, as our Lord and Redeemer. He always showed compassion for children and for the poor, for the sick and for sinners. And he became a neighbor to the oppressed and the afflicted. By word and deed he announced to the world that you are our Father and that you care for all your sons and daughters. And so with all the angels and saints, we exalt and bless your name and sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy,
merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. Gave you thanks and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord,
Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death of the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. And grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion.
Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Gustavo, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and the entire people you have made for your own.
Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters, inspiring us, words and actions, to comfort those who labor in a burden. Make us serve them truly, after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who fall asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light you face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of glory. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, with Saint Vincent, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Savior's command, conformed by divine teaching, we dare to say. Safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but look at the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with one another a sign of peace.
We call this bread God, come with you.
before he takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you.
graciously raise up the Lord, both renewed with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
After the final song, we invite all our brothers and sisters with special gifts to come forward, and we, the priests and the deacons, are going to take a picture. Thank you all for your prayers, and let's be mindful constantly of those brothers and sisters all the time are with us, whether they are one with us. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Father Hugo, as the pastor, will say.
Archbishop, on behalf of our parish, we want to welcome. Thank you for being here for the Mass, for special needs Mass with us. And also Father Peter, who's visiting us, as well as our provincial. Father Peter, welcome. And thank you all, those of you who are here visiting us as well. We want to welcome you as well. And thank the Alhambra group, who is providing refreshments after Mass in the parish hall. So everyone's welcome to attend for a refreshment there at the parish hall. Thank you.